Owners of Prestige Nails in Escondido reaches out to News 8 frustrated, wanting answers. They tell us they've done everything they can to get their salon ready to reopen.
Hoping we can open in the end of May. At the end of April.
Prestige Nails has been closed for 10 weeks.
Big business, small business, whoever that they can give the guideline to do, we can do it. You know what I mean? We can do it.
Hair salons and barbershops back in business.
We go into the same school, we take the same exam. The only difference is they do hair, we do nails.
Owner Jennifer Daffrin doesn't understand why nail salons are not included in the reopening plan by the California Department of Public Health issued by the county. Daffrin shares the email she received on Friday from the Board of Barbering and Cosmetology, a returning to work checklist.
I mean, I can follow the guidelines as much as the governor tell me to do. We were trying to do our best to keep the client safe and our health safe.
From distancing booths, adding barriers, providing protective gear, plastic covers over nail sheets, and sanitizing supplies available for employees and clients.
COVID-19 hit us really hard, and I just needed to be open. And whatever the government helping out is not even helpful, triple net. To pay for our rent.
Daffrin has owned the salon since 2018 and has spent thousands of dollars in renovations. Her longtime client says it's not just about beauty, it's therapy.
I'm diabetic, and one of the things I'm supposed to do is take care of my feet. And that's one of the reasons I see her every 5 weeks, because I have a tendency to have ingrown toenails.
Daffrin says nail care is included in the cosmetology industry.
Get your hair done, get your nails done, get your eyelashes done, get your facial done, getting your massage done, getting your tattoo done.
I got a lot of support of the clients that I did barely met, you know, but they want the salon to be open. They want me to not just close down for good. And they said whatever they can. Some of them even don't even have a job, but they say, hey, I'll send you money to I have, you know, this much and send it to you so then you can just pay your bill and keep the salon open.
Teresa Sardina, News 8.